just what the amounts are. But I would think it would be really worth their while, because you talk in terms of sometimes a whole day, you know, with people demonstrating out there. What I have told the police is that we will observe tolerance, and so, but definitely I would like them to go after persons who are indeed either carrying guns or stones, because we have to protect the interests of the citizenry against people who would inflict harm on them.
Do you see these people as a threat to your government?
No, I think it is just that, of course, Mr. Marcos and his loyalists do want to return to this country. I have indicated also that it is the express wish of the Filipino people that Mr. Marcos not return to this country, because it will again incite so many of these people against Mr. Marcos. Right now, those who are supporting me are not saying anything, and they are just supporting my government and waiting for the time when I will be able to give jobs to the unemployed. And I guess Mr. Marcos realizes this, and since he got away with most of the country's money, it is so easy for him to be financing all of these so-called demonstrators.
Is it very rather strange for you to be on this end of it? After all, you were the one that were out in the streets while there was a president here in Malacañang, and now there are people out in the streets yelling, not many to be sure, but yet they're out there in using similar techniques, if you will.
Oh yes, very similar, because I understand that before, where we used yellow ribbons, I think they use red ribbons now. And well, it is all a very different situation, and perhaps the most glaring or the most beautiful example for me anyway is when I first visited Camp Aguinaldo. You must remember that I used to visit Camp Aguinaldo before, when my husband was a political prisoner, and during those times
required nothing less than